and welcome, friends. We are so excited to have you join us as we look at how to launch your very first TimescaleDB instance using Docker. We're going to be creating this Docker container off of the official TimescaleDB Docker image. Woo, lots of words. So before we begin, we do want to make sure that we have all of the necessary tools installed and ready to go. So let's hop right on over to the desktop and get this party started. So first off, we need to make sure that we have Docker downloaded. That's, you know, pretty required for using Docker. And once you have Docker installed, you should also see this Docker desktop application icon. And most of what you're going to be doing with Docker is going to be accomplished through the terminal. However, this Docker UI can be helpful when you need to look at your images or containers, and you can see like running information and stuff. So it can be very useful. So now once we have Docker installed, we want to go ahead and open up the terminal on our computer. So I'm going to just pull that right up. And we can run, really all that we're going to do is just run this command right here. So I'm going to go ahead and put in this command. And essentially what this code is going to do is that it's going to create a new Docker container named TimescaleDB. So let's break it down a little bit, the commands, I mean. So the Docker run command is what Docker uses to run specific parameters on a new container. So this is what allows us to actually create a new container. The dash D is specifying that we want the container to start detached, which will set the container to run in the background. The dash dash name is the flag that allows us to actually name our container. So you might want to change that depending on, you know, however you want to set things up. Then the dash P is going to set up the port information for our container. So for this container, I'm using my local host, and I'm connecting my local computer's 5432 port to the container's 5432 port. So that's what I'm doing there. The dash E lets us set environmental variables. So in this case, I'm going to set my Postgres password. And then the last bit of code is really the meat of everything. And this specifies what image we want to use as the base for our container. And so what's neat is that if you don't have the image that you're looking for pulled locally, if you run this command with the image set like this, Docker will actually go ahead and download it for you and get the image installed kind of automatically for you and set up your container as well. So that's super cool, I think. And in this case, why you see the latest PG14 is because I'm specifying the Postgres version as well as the timescale version. So it's the latest TimescaleDB version along with Postgres 14. If you remember, right, TimescaleDB is an extension on Postgres, so we allow you to specify your Postgres version as well. So you could change the version of Postgres or TimescaleDB for that matter if you want to. Generally, we suggest using the latest TimescaleDB version and also the latest Postgres version that we support, of course. So that was a lot. Now you can go ahead and change the parameters around as you need. I will note that if you already have Postgres installed locally and running, you probably won't be able to use your 5432 port. So if you run into problems, that's a great place to troubleshoot. Just make sure that you change your local port, just any port that's not being used. You can connect that to your container's 5432 port. So that's just some quick tips if you run into problems. Like I said before, you can always change the version of TimescaleDB and or Postgres if you want. So, and honestly, that's it. Once you run this command, boom, You got a TimescaleDB container running and ready to go. It's very fast, which is really awesome. I hope that this video was helpful to you all. Of course, now that we have this awesome TimescaleDB instance, what next? Well, we connect to it and we have two awesome videos to show you how, one using the terminal and one using third-party tools. So make sure to check them out. Also, if you want to make sure that you don't miss any of the awesome content coming out of TimescaleDB, you want to make sure to smash that subscribe button. And of course, we always appreciate feedback via likes and comments below if you enjoyed the videos or, you know, liked them or whatever. So we really hope that you have a wonderful rest of your day and happy coding as always.